Assalamu alaikum, students. I'm your biology teacher. Welcome back to our new class of grade 10. Fortunately or unfortunately, our chapter is also number 10. And this chapter is about gaseous exchange. Inshallah, we will talk about gaseous exchange in plants as well as in humans. So, what are our objectives? I will motivate you about the subject because I will share a very interesting introductory video with you all, first of all. Then we will just recall the cellular respiration and breathing as we have discussed and learned about it in our grade 9, chapter number 7, bioenergetics. Then I will give you a review about the internal structure of leaf. Here we will learn about the internal structure of leaf for gaseous exchange, okay? And then I will introduce a new term of lenticels. And in the end, inshallah, I will share a video, I will share a thought of the day. Means I will throw a question to you all by the end of this whole lesson, okay? So now, before I start my lesson, let's have a look on the video.
Thank you.
Yes, students, I hope you have enjoyed that introductory video, which is that related to biology, because biology is science. Okay, so when we say that biology is science, it means that it is life. And I hope all of you have enjoyed my today's introductory video for biology class. So let's have a look on our today's topic, and I'm going to introduce about the topic that what is this cellular respiration. Okay, cellular respiration is the process in which the carbon hydrogen bonds in the food are broken by oxidation reduction reactions, and the energy is transformed into ATP. I know, students, that everybody of you right now can easily recall about the topic which we have learned in grade 9 in chapter number 7, that how the bonds in between the glucose, that is this carbon and hydrogen bonds, are broken down when we take in oxygen, and ultimately we get ATP. If you recall, how many ATPs we get after cellular respiration? They are 36 ATP. Yes, dear students, after breaking down the glucose, the carbon hydrogen bonds, when they are broken down, energy is released with the help of oxygen, and by the end we get energy in the form of ATP. I hope this is very clear to you all. I have just given you a brainstorming for our actual topic. Okay, now moving to the next, that what is cellular respiration. If you again recall, then aerobic respiration actually involves three main steps. Do you remember? That was glycolysis. Okay, when glucose is first broken down into pyruvic acid and we get two ATPs, then the phenomena is started in mitochondria, and over here this Krebs cycle is being started, and in this, during this reaction, we get carbon dioxide, and then the energy is going on and on, and oxygen is being involved in that step, and by the end we get water and 36 ATPs. Okay, I hope every one of you can clearly recall our grade 9 topic again. And what is breathing? Breathing is basically just a physical phenomena in the process that moves and allow in and out, moves air in and out of the lungs, and that is called breathing or pulmonary ventilation. Why we call it as pulmonary ventilation, students? Because in this case, lungs are being involved. Okay, and we had learned about the breathing, that it is the intake of oxygen and outtake of carbon dioxide in case of humans. Okay, students, so moving next to it, that is gaseous exchange in plants. This is our actual topic, students. So I hope every one of you know that plants have no organs or systems for exchange of gases with the environment. Okay, so for this, basically the leaves of the plants and the young stems, they have this stomata. Yes, I hope every one of you can look into this slide. I can show you the internal structure, what is going inside of this stomata, inside of the leaf, and that is present in the epidermis. The gaseous exchange in plants occurs mostly through this or these stomata. Remember, okay, in most of the cases, in higher plants even, the gaseous exchange occurs through these stomata. Okay, so you can see that the inner cells of the leaves and the stems have these air spaces. You can clearly see the air spaces over here among them, which help in gaseous exchange, means which give the space for the gases to let in and out of it. Okay, students, so let's move to our next topic, that what are the certain adaptations in leaves which help in the diffusion of the gases. Okay, So how are leaves adapted for diffusion? The diffusion of gases occurs in the leaves. They are adapted for this function in the following ways. And what are they? First of all, leaves are thin, means they are not having much thickness in most of the cases. Okay, in most of the cases, the leaves are thin, and this decreases the distance gases between to travel between the air and the cells. Okay, the more thinner they are, the more distance it will be decreased for the air from where we have to, from where the leaves have to take the gases and inside of the leaves. Next is that you can see that there are air spaces in between these cells, and I hope every one of you know these are called as spongy mesophyll cells, isn't it, students? They are called as spongy mesophyll cells, and spaces are there. This increases the speed of diffusion from the air to the cells inside the leaf. Okay, this will increase the speed because they get the space to travel. When the oxygen and or carbon dioxide has to get in or out, it will get space to travel. So it will definitely increase the speed of diffusion. And there are lots of stomata or pores on the undersides of the leaves. Inshallah, in the next clip, I will tell you about the animation of stomata present in the lower epidermis as well. I hope everyone is clear till now. So let's look into this internal structure of leaf now, because we said that gaseous exchange in plants, it is mostly taken place in the through the stomata. Okay, and all of you know, and all of you are well aware, students, that stomata are present on the leaves, not on the upper side only, but at the lower side or the lower epidermis, there are more stomata as compared to the upper epidermis. This concept is already well known to you all. Okay, so if you will look into the internal structure of leaf over here, I hope every one of you know that this long broad cells are called as the palisade mesophyll cells. What are they called? Palisade mesophyll cells. And you can see that they are almost and mostly they are tightly packed with each other. Got it? Then you can see over here some oval or circular shaped cells which are having spaces in between. And I already told you in the last slide, and these are called as spongy mesophyll cells. Got it? And these air spaces in between help the air or the gases to pass or to circulate in the leaf easily. And it also helps to increase the speed of diffusion. Got it, students? And here you can see the bundle sheath, means this bundle sheath is the, actually it is the vascular bundle. I hope you can recall your chapter number 4 of grade 9. You know that there are two types of vascular bundles, xylem. And these are the xylem tubes, actually ramify throughout the leaf, and these are the phloem tissues or the phloem tubes which are ramifying throughout the structure of leaf. So actually they are in appearing in this bundle shape. That's why it is called as vascular bundle. So coming next to it, students, this is the actual part which we have to concentrate, actually, that this is the main part which helps in the gaseous exchange. And adding up to your knowledge, remember, students, that the pore which is being produced in between when the stomata are open, this pore is called as stoma, while these supporting cells are called as the guard cells. Okay, what are they called? Guard cells. And in between, there is a pore-like structure which is called as stoma. And collectively, we call them stomata. Got it, students? So this is the internal structure of the leaf, in which the leaves In certain cases, they may have this waxy layer, which is called as cuticle. Okay, it is present in certain leaves, which help them to like to survive in harsh climates. Over there, they are present. Then in there is upper epidermis. No doubt stomata are also present on upper epidermis, but they are not much in number. Then going down to or going inside of this internal structure of leaf, you can find these broad and thin long cells, which are called as palisade mesophyll cells. Then over here, you can see there are oval and oval shaped structure, which are called as spongy mesophyll cells, and they have lots of air spaces in between, which help to increase the speed of diffusion and also allow gases to move inside freely. Then is the lower epidermis. No doubt sometimes cuticle is also there, but as you can see that there are more air, more stomata in the lower epidermis as compared to the upper epidermis. Got it, students? Okay, moving next to the next topic now, slide now. So this is what I want to show you actually, that how the gases comes in and they starts moving into these spongy tissues. These are the palisade tissues over here, or the palisade cells, or the palisade mesophyll cells over here, and these are the spongy cells. So as the gases moves in, they help to, or they are easily being moved or being circulated inside the leaf. Okay, so I hope till now you are clear about the gaseous exchange in plants, that generally the gaseous exchange takes place through stomata, and I have explained you in detail about the structure of leaf, its internal structure, and the structure of stomata. So what is this lenticels then? And what are the other miscellaneous ways in the plants by which they can do their gaseous exchange? Okay, so before I will go into the detail of these lenticels, I want to add up that gases can be diffused through germinal surface. It can be the case where there are no well-defined leaves are there, when there are less stomata present on upper and the lower epidermis, then in that case the gases can be diffused through germinal surface, and these gases are actually found in the soil surrounding. So from the soil directly the root cells, their skin or their epidermis takes that gaseous or do that gaseous exchange within the soil. While the aquatic plants get the oxygen dissolved in water and release carbon dioxide into the water. Okay, so as aquatic animals get the dissolved oxygen from the water in which they live, similarly the aquatic plants also get oxygen already dissolved in the water and release carbon dioxide into the water. Now what is this lenticels now? I hope every one of you can clearly see these small pore-like structures, okay? And you might have observed in woody stems, okay? In woody stems or mature roots, the entire surface is covered by a bark, okay? So this is called a bark, okay? Hard woody stems. When the plants get mature, their stems becomes woody, and we term them as bark. So there are certain pores in the layer of bark, and these are called as lenticels. Can you see that, students? What are these lenticels? These are actually these pore-like structures. That is one of the magnification of a lenticel. These are the pores. This is the skin of the bark, and you can see that these lenticels are present in this way if we have a cross section of a lenticel in a bark. Okay, but physically and apparently lenticels look like these. So in the case of hard woody plants or the mature plants, where the leaves may not be as fresh as in the young plants, they do their gaseous exchange through lenticels more than the stomata or their germinal surface. So adding up to your knowledge, students, these lenticels are the openings on fruit as well, stem as well, and the tubers that are filled with loosely connected cells that allow the passage of air. So remember, students, these lenticels are not only present in the woody stems and the mature plants or the mature roots, but yes, dear students, you can see these pores. You might have observed such type of pores many times in certain fruits, as I have given you the example of this apple right now. Isn't it, students? And even you can see these spot-like structures on potato tubers. So all these pore-like structures, either on fruits, in woody stems or the mature plants, and in tubers, all are the lenticels. And all lenticels are again being purposed for the gaseous exchange, because the situation for every plant is different. Okay, if it becomes a fruit, if it turned up into a fruit, it still need oxygen or it still need gaseous exchange. Even if this part of potato tuber has turned into an underground stem, but still it needs to get the air. So the in general, it is that gaseous exchange has to be taken place, as it is a very, very important and necessary phenomena for that plants, that they keep doing that gaseous exchange. So either they are in any situation, either in the form of this bar, this potato, this apple, they must have something, some way out to for the gaseous exchange. Isn't it, students? I hope this concept of gaseous exchange in plants is clear to you all. So before I'm going for the thought of the day, I want to recall and revise the whole lesson of today. And before I go for a recap, I want to tell you one more important point over here. Dear students, all of you know that respiration is the phenomena which keeps going on in plants throughout the day. Isn't it, students? Respiration is the phenomena which keeps going on in plants throughout the day, means either daytime or at night. While photosynthesis is a phenomena which is being done in plants only during the daytime. Okay, students? And all of you know, well aware of that photosynthesis and respiration are opposite phenomena of each other. Means during photosynthesis, the plants need carbon dioxide and water during daytime, and they release oxygen for us. But at nighttime, when the plants switch over from photosynthesis to respiration only, then they themselves need that oxygen for their own energy. Got it? So mind it, students, photosynthesis happens in plants only during the daytime, while respiration is an ongoing process throughout the day, all the time. Okay? So this is the very important point over here, which I want to add up. Okay, students? So before I will go for thought of the day today, I want to tell you or recap my today's topic. That is, we have started about cellular respiration. What it is? That it is the breakdown of carbon-hydrogen bonds in the food with the help of oxygen to produce energy in the form of ATP. You are well aware of it. Then what is this aerobic respiration and breathing? Aerobic respiration is basically a mechanical process in which energy is released, while breathing is just a physical phenomena that moves air in and out of the lungs only. Then we had started gaseous exchange in plants. I told you that the leaves and the young stems have stomata in their epidermis, and the gaseous exchange occurs through these stomata mostly in most of the plants. Then how are leaves adapted? That leaves are thin, they have air spaces between the cells, and they have lots of stomata on the undersides of the leaves. Okay, then I have briefed you about the structure, internal structure of the leaf, that how the cuticle, upper epidermis, palisade mesophyll cells, spongy mesophyll cells, lower epidermis, and definitely and surely how these stomata help to aid up in the gaseous exchange. In this way, the stomata remains open and they allow the gases to get in, and then they start moving specifically in this spongy mesophyll cells, and then they keep going on and shifting the rest of the gases to the next parts of the plants. Okay, and in this way the gaseous exchange takes place in the plants. And then in the end I have told you about the lenticels. Got it, students? This may be a new term for you, but other than stomata and lenticels, plants also do the gaseous exchange through germinal surface. And in the case of aquatic plants, they get the that gaseous exchange through the water, which is in which the oxygen is already dissolved. And what is this lenticels? These are the pore-like structures which are present in the bark of stems, woody stems, or mature roots, or the mature plants. And then these lenticels are not only present in these stems and the mature roots, rather they are present in the fruits, tubers, etc. And the purpose of all these different lenticels is the gaseous exchange. I do hope, students, you have well understand my today's lesson of gaseous exchange in plants. Now, in the end, I want to tell you, and I want to throw a thought of the day. Okay, this is my thought of the day, that why we should not sleep under the trees at night. I have given you this thought of the day specifically related to this topic which we have discussed today. If you know the answer, very good. But still, if you don't know the answer, I'm giving you the time that you take time, find out its answer, and give me its feedback to me on the Google class. Okay, on the Google class, then inshallah, I will check the answers which I have given you for this thought of the day.